Move over vitamin C. Pneumonia's got a powerful new adversary that may just blow you away how effective it is against Streptococcus pneumonia. Now keep in mind, this is a natural form of vitamin E. I'm gonna read you the citation first so you can find the information to validate what I'm saying. Then I'm gonna read you the general press release title. So bear with me on the technicality of the first citation as I read it to you. The alpha-tocopherol form of vitamin E reverses age-associated susceptibility to Streptococcus pneumonia lung infection by modulating pulmonary neutrophil recruitment, published in the Journal of Immunology, December 15, 2014. Now the little easier title, the general press release title. Extra vitamin E protected older mice from getting common type of pneumonia. This didn't just protect them. I mean, it blew it away. Now keep in mind, this is natural vitamin E. This is what you see, this little symbol, that means alpha tocopherol. A lot of parts of vitamin E, but alpha is one part, but it's a natural form. They didn't do the study on synthetic, and they didn't do the study on any other isomers of vitamin E. So keep in mind, it was done on the natural form of alpha tocopherol. Now I proceed. The researchers had a clue that vitamin E may help boost the immune system. And this is why they looked at this, and this is where it led. Earlier studies have shown that vitamin E can help regulate the aging body's immune system, as opposed to what you hear on the TV news. But our present research is the first study to demonstrate that dietary vitamin E regulates neutrophil entry into the lungs in mice, meaning they know vitamin E helps protect the lungs, but they didn't know how well it did. As I continue forward, and so dramatically reduces inflammation and helps fight off infection by this common type of bacteria, Streptococcus pneumonia. And this is what they did. Aged mice with better control diet were exquisitely more susceptible. I mean, the control diet meaning the mice didn't get very much vitamin E. Basically like the general population of the United States or the average human. So the ones that just got the regular daily requirement of vitamin E were extremely susceptible to pneumonia, much more than young mice. At 2 days post-infection, aged mice suffered 1,000 higher pulmonary bacterial burden, 2.2-fold or higher levels of neutrophil recruitment to the lungs, and a 2.25-fold higher rate of lethal septicemia. Now, for the mice that got a little extra vitamin E, about 10 times the recommended daily allowance for human, otherwise known as 200 IUs of natural vitamin E. This is what happened to that little extra vitamin E in the diets of these animals. Strikingly, alpha tocopherol supplementation of aged mice resulted in a 1,000-fold lower bacterial lung burden and full control of infection. Repeat it, 1,000-fold lower bacterial burden and full control of infection. That's just vitamin E. That's not some weird drug or pharmaceutical. That's just simple dietary natural vitamin E. Now to proceed forward. The older mice fed a diet containing extra amounts of vitamin E, the equivalent of about 200 IUs a day of natural vitamin E, consumed by humans, or about 10 times the recommended daily allowance, but well below the upper limit, were far more resistant to the bacteria than older mice that had a normal amount of vitamin E in their diet. And to reiterate and conclude, compared to the mice that had normal amounts of vitamin E, typical RDA, in their diet, the mice fed extra vitamin E, 200 IUs around there, 1,000 times fewer bacteria in the lungs, 2 times fewer the number of white blood cell neutrophils. Reason? The reduced numbers of bacteria and white blood cells resulted in less lung damage. So they need all those white blood cells because the vitamin E was protecting the lungs. In the older mice who received extra vitamin E, these mice were able to control the infection as efficiently as young mice. So if you want to hedge your bet against pneumonia, and this study in animals does translate, or I should say, it should translate to the same in humans. Man, just 200 IUs of extra natural vitamin E could go a long way. So pneumonia has a new adversary, natural vitamin E. Ralph Turchiano, signing off once again.